Hey guys, Thunder E here, and hopefully you guys are at home safe and sound, and of course, trying to stay healthy. Now, I know you guys have been looking forward for this video, so here it is, my LG V60 ThinQ gaming review. Now, let's not waste any time and do some gaming. So the LG V60 ThinQ is the latest from LG. It's a V series phone, which usually comes in the later half of the year, but we have it here. And this device is one I'm going to look at from a non-gaming perspective. The reason I say this is because LG V60 ThinQ is the only device that offers a single and dual screen alternative for whatever your needs are. And that comes into play quite effectively for gaming because that's something LG is supporting. So design-wise, the device looks like a standard smartphone. Granted a premium smartphone, but it still has a very standard feel. It's not as flashy as other devices you see this year. It's got a notch in the on the display, which is a 6.8-inch display. It's a lovely display though. It's actually quite sharp and effective. And it's just got a very standard look and feel. Now, this device also has a camera layout at the back with, you know, a camera array. And first off the bat, when you look at it, you go, that looks like a Galaxy S10 Plus. Not gonna lie, that's what it does look like. But I think it's still a solid design. I think it's simple and quite effective. The cameras are pretty good too, by the way. And you've got some really nice photos from the camera. So stay tuned for our camera video on that to see some low lights and all that stuff. We also have an 8K camera video. But we're talking about gaming and how does this affect this device? So it's powered by a Snapdragon 865 processor, which we know is a very powerful processor for what you're looking for gaming-wise, right? But so when you're playing games on the LG V60 ThinQ, whether it's Call of Duty, PUBG, Fortnite, they are quite effective, they work out really well. Things are really smooth, gameplay performance is fast, it's solid, it's good. You know, I like the performance you get out of this device. And that's something, just as a gamer picking up a smartphone that's solid, it nails off the bat. Now, it comes with 8 gigs of RAM, 128 gigabytes of storage. You can expand it with 2 terabytes of storage, micro SD. And this is UFS 2.1 storage for the device. Now, the big thing, of course, is the dual screen case. LG introduced this last year with the G8, the G8X, the V50, and now the V60. What this case does adds a level of extra functionality for your device that we've never had before in a smartphone. And LG isn't trying to load this up with their own custom software, which personally I wish they did to add a little bit more fluidity to it. But this allows you to do simple things like, hey, look, having, you know, your YouTube on one display and then maybe your email or a web browser in the second display. And you can also do multi-screen on each individual display as well. So you've got a multitude of displays to use. So as a gamer, this brings a whole lot of opportunity for your gaming experience. You can play it like a Nintendo DS with the top screen showing your gameplay, the bottom screen, your controls, or you could even play one game on one screen and another game on the other screen, which is fine. It works out pretty well. You can actually switch between both of the games. That's something, of course, a lot of people will not be doing, but you care about that experience having you know, the top display and the bottom display having your controls. And how does that work? So we tried out a couple of games, Call of Duty, PUBG, Fortnite, the whole shebang. And one thing that's really important is that you can customize your controls for any single game you have. That is actually pretty cool. You can go in, set your controls for the games you like, and you're good to go. One of the best games that works with it, of course, is King of Fighters. And that is just really awesome to play in that format. It really takes you back to those old school days of gaming, which is great. Now, the other thing to note also here is that what you have with this device is something that allows you to also get into your FPS gaming quite effectively. Not as effectively as I would like though, because one of the things this case is missing are shoulder buttons or trigger buttons, which I think if LG had included it, would have been taking this device to a whole nother level and made this probably the quintessential device for gaming, because you pop it out of the case, It's a smartphone. There's nothing gaming crazy about it, but you pop it back into the case, then you've got a full-fledged gaming device with trigger buttons, remappable buttons that you already have there, and you are good to play any game effectively, whether it's Call of Duty, Fortnite, or PUBG. And that's where the limitation comes in with this case. Because those trigger buttons are not there, playing shooters like Fortnite, PUBG, or Call of Duty, you actually have to go to auto fire, which makes it easier for you to fire, or you play in a claw grip, which kind of takes away the whole point of having a dual screen device, right? So that's just something to take note, but it's still effective well enough. It still works well. I think that's something LG can easily remedy by releasing, say, a gamer-centric case for this, or just having it built in for the very next version. LG, please. Release a case with trigger buttons. It would make this absolutely awesome. Now, this device also has a ton of other features that adds to your gaming experience. You've got a headphone jack with a quad DAC, which is the only flagship device that has a headphone jack that gives you supreme audio, better than anything you get on Bluetooth, better than anything you get on any wireless device right now. And that can add to that gaming experience, especially listening to headshots, you're listening to gunfire, you're playing your games quite extensively with this. And I think that's really nice. Now, you've also got fast charging on there. And my buddy TK Bay did a fast charging test. It takes like an hour, 43 minutes. Not as fast as I would like, but it's still fast enough to give you the kind of functionality you want in there. There is wireless charging on the device as well, so you have those capabilities. Now, the case itself comes with Pogo pins and not a USB Type-C port, but it comes in an adapter that kind of just slips on top of your USB-C cable, so you can use it directly with this. And it is a nice additive as well. Now, battery life on this is great. 5,000 milliamp battery really works out well. Playing pretty much, you know, the whole day trying to shoot this video, played for about maybe 5-6 hours, and I ate up about 50% of my battery. That I think was kind of solid and good for the kind of gameplay and what I was trying to showcase in this video. I think a lot of people will like that. I also know that in terms of temperatures, while gaming with the device and gaming with the dual screen, the max temperature we got was 95 degrees. And yes, you know, that's on par with what you have with the S20 series. So there's a lot this device does well. And I think a lot of people like the fact that this device games well and brings a lot of functionality. The camera is pretty solid with its low light photography. We've also got really good battery life, great standby time. The one thing that I put in the downer are the speakers. They're not as loud as I would like and not as punchy as I would like. Yeah, headphone jack is great. Speakers, not so much. I think overall with the LG V60 ThinQ, there is a lot to like with this device. And one of the most important things is the price point. You're looking at a price point at $800 for a flagship device with a Snapdragon 865 and $899 when you're picking up this case here. So that is something that is well priced, especially when you're looking at most flagships are starting at $1,100 for this kind of package here you're looking at. So LG's come to play. LG's provided something that is a solid phone, is a gaming phone, and also has a good camera. So what else can you ask for, except maybe some improvements here and there to make this, I think, overall beneficial for everyone who's looking for a smartphone. So if you have any questions, any comments, guys, let me know. Otherwise, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Always enjoy your entertainment and be safe.